after yesterday's scientific day. It's the a little bit more rowdy brother of a more disciplined and organized sister that came before yesterday with lots of good presentations. Before I start, I wanted to do two things, some household points, and then, first of all, I wanted to talk about, I just wanted to remember the fact that, you know, last Wednesday we had a team as MSF going out in Bosangoa. They were held up on the outskirts of Bosangoa, and in the incident that lasted about 40 minutes, our driver, Arseng, was killed, and he and his team returned soon thereafter. But yeah, the activities have now been suspended, and of course, our thoughts are particularly with the family of Arsène, but also with the team members that have lived through that horrific experience, and with the people of Central African Republic, whose country has been blighted for such a long time. And this is just the last incident, but there have been many before, particularly incidents affecting the population, and not excluding humanitarians, but primarily the population. And this is a sad reminder of how bad and how sad and how dangerous the situation is in Central African Republic for the population. So I just wanted to start with that. It's a sad note, but I thought it was necessary to do so anyway. And then I will now move towards some very practical notes. We have a big day ahead of us. If during that day there would be a fire, then you would have to leave through the front, and then you would have to turn left twice in order to be able to gather outside so that we can figure out what is happening here within the building itself. The online audience might have the pleasure of watching live what is happening, but you will be outside waiting until you get the all clear sign to be able to come back. So that's one thing. The second issue is that there are toilets in this beautiful building. You have to go to the central atrium down the stairs, then you will find them there. I would like you to come back promptly from the breaks that have been scheduled. The breaks, we need you to come back in a prompt manner, because we have a huge online audience, and they will be signing in for particular sessions too, and therefore it's very important that you come back. And please don't sit too much on the stairs. If you can avoid it, and move into the middle of the seats, in order for people who come a little bit late to move in very swiftly and promptly, and without too much ado. We have, like I said, an online audience. There was a massive following. We've hit all the targets, exceeded all the targets that were set for this year already. Last year, the events were watched in over 115 countries with 52,000 viewers. 5,200 viewers. this year we are set in order to be reach or even exceed that number again. So a huge welcome to everyone online, and I'm hoping that they will participate in the same manner that you do here in this room. We also have a nice innovation, which is that we are translating into French, and the translators, they started working yesterday. There was some wobbles in the beginning, but it went fine during the day, and now they're fully warmed up, and they will be translating all the contributions and all the questions and exchanges and debates in the course of today. So with that, let me introduce and have a couple of introductory remarks to this second Innovation Day. It is essential that the innovation projects undertaken by MSF deliver benefits to the health of the populations that we serve. We also want to know if the work presented here is worth it too. So we asked last year's presenters about the impact that their work had had. You can see the summary results near the back of your abstract booklet, but in brief, the vast majority of projects presented last year had an impact on programs, which is fantastic. However, Few had an effect on policies, or presenters weren't sure if they had or not. In only two projects did the presenters say that they had no effect on programs, policies, or other areas. And many respondents were not able to say if their projects had achieved its aims. Sometimes this was due to the fact that it was a process rather than a product, but it suggests that more effort is needed around setting aims and conducting evaluations in some areas of innovation. And 75% said that presenting at a scientific day directly benefited their work, which is very good news, particularly also for the presenters of this year. At last year's day, there was a presentation showing that insulin was heat stable and could be stored without refrigeration. This has the potential to revolutionize how we deliver care for diabetes, but so far this hasn't resulted in change in our programs. And so we need to improve mechanisms to translate innovation and research to our own operations and our own guidelines. Last year too, there were questions raised by the audience on the ethical oversight of innovation projects. In response, an MSF ethics framework for innovation has been developed and is used in submission process for this year's day. It's a work in progress. A draft version is printed towards the back of your booklet. An article outlining its development is currently undergoing peer review, and we hope it will be shown in action in the exciting innovation pitch session at the end of today, when it is one of the criteria for judging the project pitches. The other major challenge that came from the audience last year was on the need for better information sharing amongst innovators, and therefore I'm very delighted to announce that MSF has just launched an innovation Twitter account at MSF Innovation to communicate about MSF's innovation projects and help innovators communicate their work. We have also recognized over the past year in particular that MSF faces challenges in how it manages relations with industrial and commercial partners. This is especially challenging in innovation partners where software and tech companies with which we need to partner are very differently structured to our traditional NGO and academic institutional partners. Working out how to manage these relationships for the benefit of our patients is an important consideration for the coming years. This year, we have a few innovations in content. I've already mentioned the innovation pitch session at the end of today. I understand the winners will be awarded practical support from an MSF innovation unit to help them realize their project's ambitions. We also have a demonstration session taking place over lunch, where you see firsthand some of the projects presented here, as well as others such as 3D printing for hospital design, amongst others. We have an extended lunch break of 90 minutes to allow you to see those demos and ask questions of their designers, as well as catch up with your colleagues. But we have not forgotten about our online audience. Last year, across all the Scientific Day events in London, India, and Zimbabwe, we reached an audience of over 5,200 people in 115 countries. And yesterday, already 4,000 people tuned in. Our online audience is a huge part of our day, and we are very grateful to have them. So over lunch, they will watch interviews with a demonstration presenter, so they don't miss out on this part of the day. And these will be recorded immediately after the first keynote, which is why you will see some people leaving the auditorium to take part in filming. We also realize that many people are tuning in online for particular presentations, and for this reason, like I said before, we ask you to help us to keep to time by returning in time to sessions and for speakers to keep to time throughout the day. Last year's keynote speaker, Kenneth Couquier, challenged us to think about big data. I'm very glad to say that our first presentation is on a project that used various innovative types of data analysis to help us overcome the many extreme difficulties in delivering assistance to besieged areas of Syria without being able to directly access those populations. We're also very fortunate to have the keynote speaker from yesterday's Scientific Day event, Zaher Sahloul of the Syrian American Medical Society, joining the demonstration session at lunch to show the telemedicine system His organization uses to provide support to health staff in intensive care units in besieged areas and other areas of Syria. We hope the challenges raised by this year's keynotes will likewise be addressed in the coming year. After lunch, we welcome Zubin Damania, a physician and founder of an innovative healthcare startup, who also achieved viral fame as alter ego ZDocMD. A doctor who raps about the state of healthcare and the issues raised when technology hinders rather than helps healthcare delivery. But first, we welcome Killian Kleinschmidt, the ex-head of Zatri refugee camp in Jordan and the founder of Switchboard, which uses technology to connect resources with the needs of people in disadvantaged areas. He will be speaking on the need for innovative thinking, providing humanitarian aid to refugee and displaced populations.